Radio. Thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source, your source for celeb news. Now, today we got Meek Mill paying it forward. That's what I'm talking about. We got Lauryn Hill's daughter. Man, I just spoke about Lauryn Hill yesterday. We got Cardi B defending Kylie, CeeLo weighing in, and we have Kanye West on Jay-Z. Yes, lots to cover for today. Yo, thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source. If this is your first time to the channel, be sure to subscribe. Make sure you hit that notification bell on the side. Join the notification gang in the cut. And make sure you like it in advance, because I'm sure we got something lined up for you today. Hey, yo, we had a battle already. We already announced our two winners last night. We got winner number one and winner number two from last night's video. Make sure you go into yesterday's video and click link number one. Not click link number one. Put in number one if you want the first link to win, and put number two if you want the second link to win, okay? We also had our honorable mentions that we made sure we shouted out. So make sure you check yesterday's video just in case you missed it. Now, first on deck is your boy Meek Mill. Now, Meek Mill's been having quite the year. He found himself in the middle of a messy back and forth with a blogger, recently had a baby, also had a breakup that was semi-public, followed by more mess with a blogger, and then fortunately, he didn't quite bite the bait with the blogger, but that's probably because he's currently busy helping folks with prison reform. Yes, prison reform. Now, this should be the thing that makes Meek Mill stand out more than a lot of other artists, okay? Because he's focused on working prison reform. Now, the little people often want to see artists giving back to the community and helping out and producing positive change. Now, we reported to you not too long ago that Jewel Santana was recently released from prison. But what we didn't mention to you was that Meek Mill had a hand in helping Jewel's get out of prison. Now, the prison system is a messy labyrinth, complete with twists and turns that lock people in more ways than one. Now, Meek, however, knows his way a little bit around that maze and got in touch with Jewel Santana's wife and directed her to a lawyer that he knew his way around the system. And that same lawyer not only navigated the system, but helped Jewel Santana with his release. Now, we all know it's about proper representation, and your boy did not disappoint. Now, here is where the magic happens, okay? You're like, yo, that wasn't magical enough. Yeah, it was, but there's some more magic, okay? Jewel Santana decided to also now work with nonprofits to overturn sentences of other inmates that were unjustly sentenced. See, now this is what I'm talking about. Artists using their power and their influence to better the lives of others. Yo, this is fantastic. Big up to Jewel Santana. Extra special salute to Meek Mill. That kind of paying it forward creates a legacy that one could be proud of. Yo, respect to the highest, right? Now, here's another thing that gets respect. Discipline. Now, of course, some people can go over the top with it, and I'm not speaking about that. I'm speaking about proper discipline, and especially to children who need it above all. Yesterday, I mentioned Lauryn Hill as being one of my favorite female artists. She looked good, she could sing, she could rap, you know what I'm saying? She didn't degrade herself in the process. So, you know, some of you are like, degrade? Degrade like how? I'm not biting that one, okay? I'm not biting the bait on that, all right? Now, you know exactly what I mean. She didn't have to resort to, that. But you know how it is. Regardless of how much respect the public can give, oftentimes your children will see to it that they strip you of all the dignity you may have built up in society. Because children, okay? You thought you had it together. No, children will teach you quicker than anyone else. You don't know crap. Sit your behind down making sense. What are you, stupid? Lauryn Hill's daughter, Selah, whose name actually means, man, sit down, pause, and just think for a second, okay? Just meditate for a second. Hey, Lauryn Hill's daughter decided to come out and discuss Lauryn Hill's parenting skills. Now, in my head, I'm thinking she has to say something heinous in order for me to have a problem with Lauryn. The girl said she was spanked. Not good enough, okay? She said her mother, Lauryn Hill, was always angry and always spanked them. I'm thinking most children do things that often result and a stern checking. Okay? Take a listen.
Because it's like, I feel like a part of me stopped growing at the age that my dad left. So whenever that stopped, you know, like, I feel like something just stopped. Or maybe it never grew. It never developed. So once, especially when it comes to men, oh shit, I did not see that. Oh, okay. Especially when it comes to men, like males in my life, they bring out this such a dark, dark, dark thing inside of me, because I'm like, I feel like I need them. I feel like I need them. I need them. Like, but I hurt them because I'm mad at them, because I'm mad at my father for not being around. But like, I need them because I don't have a father, so I need someone. So it's like, I need you, but I'm hurting you, but I need you, but I'm hurting you, but, and it makes no sense. And it's not that I have no control over it, but it feels like I have no control over it. It feels like I have no control over myself. It feels like I have no control. Like when that clicks, when it clicks, it might as well just, I might as well just start, like, I look like this. You know, like, I literally look like this. Like, I start glitching. And, or not glitching, but, you know, I just lose my shit. Because I'm just like, yo, something is not right. Something is just not right, and I just don't understand what it is. And I think yesterday it finally clicked that I have severe daddy issues, like very severe daddy issues. And so I've just been like, and now I'm just looking up, like, what does it mean to have a father? What does that feel like? What does that look like? Crystals, definitely fuck with that. Inner child meditation, all those things. No, I'm definitely gonna go to therapy. I mean, that's, of course, I've been to therapy a million times, but sometimes I just feel like they don't get straight to the fucking point. Like, it's like, to me, this is an urgent matter, and for them, I'm just another one of their patients. And so for me, it's like life or death. Like, if you don't give me a tool by the end of this conversation, the next time we talk, I'm gonna have something else to say. Like, something else I fucked up on. And like, I just need to know how to handle it better, handle my emotions better. But it's just like, there's just this hole. I will DM you, let me write it down. There's just a hole. And it's sad because the inner child in me, even right now as I'm talking, I'm like kicking my feet inside, because I'm just like, I don't want to take responsibility for this. Like, I don't want to, because why should I? Because my fucking, like, this is not even for me to take responsibility for. This is my father and my mother who weren't around, or who fucking, like, and now I'm here fixing myself from their shit. Like, when do they? Like, what do I fucking, I don't even know where to go. I just don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. But obviously, it can't go on like this. It can't go on like this, because I just have no control. Like, I lose complete control over myself, for real. Like, I really lose complete control of myself. Like, I really do. It's so toxic. Like, it's toxic and abusive. But it's like, and I just come back to, I just revert to that same fucking, like, 8-year-old, 7-year-old, 6-year-old who, like, was watching their parents argue. You know, who was watching their parents screaming and fighting. And so that's how I know I'd handle it. Screaming and fighting. Throwing shit. Yelling. Cursing. You're not, you know, like, abusing someone, because that's what I saw. And then also just growing up in a household where, like, my parents used to discipline through physical abuse as well. So they would just spank us, you know, like, and it's not their fault fully, because they got beat and my dad didn't have a dad. His father died when he was 9 years old, you know, so that I can understand. But it's just like, it's just so hard. And it's just like, the thing is that I can talk about it right now as a rational, I mean, honestly, this is a little more progressive than anything that I've ever done, but like, I can talk about it here rationally, but like the emotions of it, the deep emotions. And part of how I feel like we as humans hide ourselves from ourselves is by rationalizing everything. You know, you rationalize. You can always, like, your brain tricks you into thinking that you're okay because you're so smart. And it's like you're too smart for your own good, or you're so smart you're dumb. Because realistically, that doesn't matter. None of that fucking.
No, I just want to highlight the fact that children, kids, can get you to a point where you can't quite understand why they say or do the things that they do after you've taught them better. You taught your kid during a pandemic, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Now, case in point, you came on Instagram Live and you told me about your mother's disciplining methods. I'm not even your close friend, okay? What if I wanted to harm her and needed as much dirt as I could get? And here you are telling me about how she had y'all on some slave-ish. Kids don't understand until they have kids. I used to think, why is my pops bringing a ruckus to me like this, man? This dude's tripping. And then, look, you don't even have to have kids. Just talk to one. Teach it math. Or teach it reading, or something, whatever. Some kids learn by speech, others, you know what I'm saying? You know how it is. Cardi B found herself coming to the defense of none other than Kylie Jenner. Now we know that Cardi released that new video with Megan Thee Stallion, and, you know, folks were upset with the video because Kylie Jenner was in it. Some people say, hey, you know, what's wrong with Kylie Jenner being in it? Well, some folks thought that she was out of place. Others thought, why does she get to walk around all dressed and through the video while all the other women have to put in the hard work and engage in hyper promiscuousness? Try to spell that. You know what I'm saying? They're pushing the narrative of women of color have to do a whole lot more for attention than other women. Now, some believe that after Megan Thee Stallion incident and her unfollowing Megan, that she should not appear in a video alongside Megan. Petitions were even drafted to remove Kylie from the video, which I find to be quite comical. Now, Cardi has decided to come to Kylie's defense. She stated on, what is this, Twitter? Whatever, social media. She said, why did I put Kylie on my music video? I like when she starts it off with the question. You know what I'm saying? Just in case you didn't know. Why did I put Kylie on my music video? She treated my sister and my daughter so lovely at her kids' birthday party. I like that. Travis and Offset, are real close, and Kris Jenner has given me advice on certain things I ask for, and her husband real cool with mine. Simple. That's her reason why Kylie was in the video, and that's it. So if you have a problem with that, oh well, you know what I'm saying? You ain't giving no advice, okay? You should have gave her a little bit of advice and treated her kids nice at the birthday party. Now, another big name has decided to have a bit of a problem with Kylie's inclusion in the video, and that person is CeeLo Green, just the kind of buzz Cardi was looking for. Now, in a discussion with Far Out Magazine, CeeLo stated that there was a time and a place for adult content in music, and that video, referring to Cardi B's video, was not the time. In fact, he stated, quote, A lot of music today is very unfortunate and disappointing on a personal and moral level. There was a time when we were savvy enough to code certain things. I guess he means like, you know, you're down with OPP, yeah, you know, remember that? That was all coded, okay? We could express to those it was meant for with the style of language we used. But now music is shameless. It's sheer savagery, close quote. Now, if you think that's raw and uncut, he went on to say, quote, attention is also a drug and competition is around. Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion, now they keep calling them out, they are all more or less doing similar salacious gesturing to kind of get into position. I get it. The independent woman and being in control, the divine femininity, you say that three times fast. Femininity and sexual expression, I get it all, but at what cost? You have the heads of state, like Nicki Minaj or someone who is up there, in accolade, success, visibility, a platform to influence. Nicki could be effective in so many other constructive ways, but it feels, get this, desperate. Close quote. Now, how do I feel about that? You know what? I think I might slightly agree. Listen, if I made a song, right? Dudes are guilty too when it comes to drugs and guns. Desperate, okay? Desperate, all right? Now, we ain't just beating on women, but oftentimes a lady will clean a brother up, sanitize him, if you will. A good woman, all right? Now, let me highlight that. Listen, if I made a song, right? And all I spoke about in my song was my genitalia. Then in every video, I was grabbing my genitalia, spoke about how I was gonna slap you in the mouth with it, and then I went into the juices and the liquids and all this other stuff. You're gagging now, right? Yeah, well, that's what they're essentially doing, right? Only problem is, I mean, the only difference is they're beautiful, okay? But whatever. That's what he's saying. Saying, you know, they're doing, look, you don't have to agree. Dudes are guilty too. We say, we like you, you know, we like you when you do this. We like you when you do that. We don't want to hear your higher thoughts. Just give me the animalistic stuff. Okay? I think that's where he was going with all that. But look, this is one man's opinion. Okay? If you don't like it, you could get your ears tickled somewhere else. Now, Kanye West, I have to tell you, you came for the news, didn't you? Someone said, whenever his hair turns blonde, he goes next level, right? Make of that what you will. A complaint was filed against Kanye West in the state of Wisconsin, asking that he be blocked from the ballot. Did Kanye respond? Of course he responded. He stated, the Wisconsin Democratic Party has hired a private investigator to look into his street team and are essentially spying on him. He called it an organized effort of harassment and intimidation. And he stated, the man who submitted the complaint is, quote, a man who is widely reported to be a front for the Democratic Party, close quote. If he lost it when he believed systems were working against him, when he was trying to, you know, create, can you imagine, politically, the forces that would rise against him and the result of what that would all be. He would go full Super Saiyan on these cats. He would need all the help he could get. So, and finally, about 9 years ago, Watch the Throne came out. 2018, Kanye tweeted that Watch the Throne, the sequel, would come out, but it never did. Now Kanye, at that time, he said there would never be another Watch the Throne 2 because he said, quote, you know why? Because that's the reason why I wasn't on the song, Pop Style. I wasn't on this song because of Hov, close quote, highlighting the tension between them. But you know how it is. After he's had a little bit of time to reflect and think about the good old days, Kanye recently came through and posted, quote, I miss my bro. Real talk, close quote. Now, last time he said something like this in public, which we know could be said in private, but he said it in public. Last time he said this, it was about Lil Baby. And Lil Baby was like, I didn't even know you were trying to get up with me, okay? But then, of course, we saw Lil Baby promptly getting off the plane at the ranch. Now, hopefully, we know how Jay-Z rolls. You'll probably never hear about it, because he's always moving behind the scenes. Respect, I like that. But hopefully, Kanye's out loud thought will be met with an appearance or phone call from Jay. Yo, let us know what you think. Is it possible that we could hear something from Kanye and Jay-Z once again? And if we do, how excited are you about that? And what are your thoughts about kids getting the paws put on them? And ladies, what are your thoughts about what CeeLo Green said? Yo, let us know what you think. Be sure to like, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for tuning in to Celeb Source, your source for celeb news.